Hi everyone, welcome to Teching, or more likely welcome to ACTA. If you would like to have some mate or coffee, then you should go upstairs for it. So I'm going to call the teams one by one. It's around 5 to 10 minutes about your what you need still, or what happened between the two meetings. So let's get started, I suppose. Also, if you have some lightning talks, because it's scheduled in, but I didn't get anything registered yet, then please talk to me. So let's see which teams are here. And someone should open the door, please. Thanks. No, it's not in order. I have two mobiles because this is opening the door. Let's see how many teams we have here. I'm going with the teams from the wiki, but the first one is Bar.
Do you want to go over what we do today? Introduce the agenda and stuff like that?
That can, but it's going to change because in the agenda it has a lot of stuff, but for example, lightning talk I don't have at the moment. So. And the next, we usually start at 12 till 14, 2 o'clock, yeah, it's 2:18 now, and start with the program for the project and their status. That's between 5 and 10 minutes. And also, if you have any question for the teams, then please ask. And we have then lightning talks, if we have any. And around 5 o'clock is a team assignment. And from technically 5:40, that's networking with teams. And around 6 o'clock we close, and we order food, or it will have some food also at Teching because it's a 5 years anniversary. So after 6 o'clock, everybody welcome to the party at Teching. So. That's about it for the agenda. So let's see if I have. Go ahead.
There's a pad which is just posted on IS.
There you go. So do I have team Bar here, or we start with you because you are the longest one? And yes.
Yeah. Well.
Okay. Then we start with Attila.
Well, someone from Bar is over there. Either way, I think it's a good idea to give an update on what we're doing from project lighting and the field and everything. So for the past month, I've been in the Himalayas and offline. So what I did before I went on holiday was to finalize the negotiations with scouting on the field. And I was hoping to have it signed by now. But there are still 2 points, and we have to fill it out, and then everything is expected to be arranged. Are there any questions about the location that everyone has or someone has? We can address that as well, or have some discussion on that. Yeah, sorry. Just yesterday. So, okay. It was asked if during the field day we had a big A1 map of the field and suggestions where what location would be. Well, we took that to design where the tents are going to be. Some of the suggestions weren't very practical. Someone put, for example, the storage part in the middle of a forest, which didn't work. But, well, we plan to finalize the where everything is going to be. We'll sit down today, actually, because that's also part of the permit that I'd like to give some explanation about. We hope to have that online soon, because we need to finish it for the permit anyway. Talking about the permit, so the status is that we had to wait for the municipality to give us new forms that we have to fill in, new procedures, etc., that we had to follow. We were supposed to get that by the 1st of December, but they already sent it. That means that we have to submit a formal proposal with drawings and evacuation plans and everything, and how we're going to handle everything, etc. There has been a meeting with the municipality already about what kind of event we are and what they are expecting of us. They had no idea what kind of event we are. They were asking, like, okay, how are you going to get your visitors without doing any flyering? that kind of thing. So, that didn't work out. One thing that I'd like to emphasize on is there was a bit of a discussion on IRC about drug usage. And because of the local municipality doesn't allow drug usage, we have to be clear that in the Netherlands, drug usage isn't legal. It's condoned. That means that in the regulations for all events, it has to be stated that drug usage isn't allowed. If someone decides to do that, that's another story. So we have to be clear on that what the policy is and how it will be enforced. The idea is that we'll finish the map and everything, and we'll have another meeting with the municipality the beginning of February, and we'll go over everything, and hopefully we'll get a final permit about 2 months before the event. And that's normal, and that happened the last time as well, so there's nothing to worry about that on that part. Are there any questions on that? The idea was to have a maximum on 6,000. That doesn't mean that actually that number of people have to be there, but that's a broken laptop. For safety reasons, you are in a certain category with the number of people. And we're well over the category already, so you can just submit for a certain number of people, and if you get there, it doesn't matter. But changing a number of people later on, that will cause more problems.
Yes, that's why I'm asking. Is it a lot harder than, for example, 5,000, 6,000, same forms, same stuff? Just
it's all the same. I believe that the previous limit is at 2,000. Well, yeah, I believe that there is a different category if you go over 10,000. That won't fit on the field anyway. And I don't think that we want an event for 10,000 people anyway. Given that the last CCC was around 5,000 visitors, then this seemed to be a nice value. Sorry, I didn't. Yeah, the scouting had their own field. It was asked if evacuation plans and et cetera aren't already available from the scouting. They have. They have provided us with a lot of plans that they have for their event. They have a large event that's called Scout In. It was last year for around 5,000 people as well. So they have evacuation plans, fire escape plans, et cetera. And we'll definitely use a lot of that. But we're not the same event. So, yeah.
Do we have a legal person or somewhere on the field to advise us for the contract, for example, with this drug usage and stuff like that?
If we have a legal advising, yes. So we have one from the company from McFly, who can advise us on legal issues. And for the contract, we had another person that advises on legal issues. So, yeah. Okay, if we can make a special plan, I assume safety.
No, this is mostly about the permission at the moment. I'd like to not put as little as possible. Do you want to?
Sorry, what kind of plan would you like to have for the children? Could you elaborate a bit? Okay, if we can take into so basically if we can take into account that there are children on the field and how we are going to handle that, I'll make a note of that. Yeah, of course. If we need special permissions for heavy machinery, I think we need to discuss this offline. I'm not sure what you already have, and I'm not aware of all the details of what's needed or not. Yeah, of course. So, what a municipality or in general wants to know is, okay, what are you doing and how are you planning to make that secure? So, if you have special machinery, then I think that we should mention that and say that we have certified people using that and et cetera. And that exactly. But I understand the question. Thank you. Okay. I'll be sitting down later with Ruud for locations on what is where on the map. A lot of the things are already defined, mostly for practical reasons. But if you have any input, feel free to walk to us and maybe we can have a look what the possibilities are. Other teams, since I'm from project leading, I'm responsible for infrastructure, that also includes tents and such. I have some quotes from tent suppliers, the same that are being used by the scouting, so they already know the field, and that makes it easy to use them as a supplier. We have one special tent, McFly will be arranging that for different purposes, or that will be a lecture tent, but it has a different layout. So we're also planning to give the possibility to rent tents for visitors, for villages. But people can also bring their own tents. So we have to see that from permit-wise. There are some regulations to that. If you have a tent that's larger than 24 square meters, then we need an evacuation plan, we need building plans, et cetera, et cetera. Details on the tent and how it's fireproof. So, you can bring your own tent, but it has to be less than 25 square meters. That's how it works. If you place together four tents,
When is it that one tent?
When it's separated by a certain distance.
When you
put a
tarp
over
it, or if you need security certification, it's fired.
Yeah, so that is what...
You can either go through the bureaucratics, or have a tent that is less than 25 centimeters. If you put a tarp
meters.
It's one tent.
Okay. I had one other idea that I was mailing with an organization on. I think the Breno came up with that. Can I get access to the beamer? I'm not sure. Okay, well, if you give me 2 minutes to connect it, then I can show it on the beamer as well. Oh yeah, oh you already have it. Okay. Yeah. So I think that Brenno came up with this. This is a Dutch company. It's called Car Tent, and what they offer is cardboard tents. well, it's they're smaller than 25 square meters. I can assure you that. Either way, they're weatherproof for multiple days. I explicitly asked that since we have had water rain, so it's it needs to be. Yeah. So either way, the idea is that you could rent tents like this. You could even get a logo on it or get them printed. They deliver it. They have the ability to also provide sleeping bags, sleeping mattresses. Basically, you can get everything for, I believe that the total package is around 30 euros. And it's environmental proof, and they arrange everything for you. I haven't said anything in stone yet or arranged anything, but what I wanted to get back is if this is interesting for people. So the idea is that you don't have to bring your own tent. Everything is ready. They can even set it up for you, and we can just say, hey, there's your tent. Well, one of the advantages is that it doesn't get hot in the morning if the sun shines on it. I was wondering if, what you guys think of this. Well, if we have donations and things, then we can print it on top. That would be a possibility, yeah. That's correct. Well, yeah, well, so.
That will just kill the agreement that we have.
Yeah. Defy the little bit like in do-it-yourself movement when other people provide a tent for you, like you could also just stay in a hotel.
But we're in a different, like, when you take a hotel, buying a 30 euro tent.
Right. So it's just a question if it's interesting for you guys.
Well, that's one of the things for an international visitor. Obviously, if you're living in a half an hour drive away, it's not that interesting. Okay, well, if you have any opinion on that, feel free to walk to me. I think it would be interesting for at least international visitors, and we can see what we can do with that. One other team, Timo isn't here today, he's moving. He's team lead of the power team. But he's indicated that he already did that for 20 years and he's willing to help out, but he doesn't want to run over the field for 2 weeks. I've sent an email earlier, we need power people. Both that are able to do planning with and a rollout on the field itself. While the latter isn't that important, we can get those people later. But for the planning part, we do need some people. So if you know someone who might be interested in doing that, let them contact us because we're not getting a lot of response on that. Yeah, so. Yeah. So so they have an infrastructure locally, and I was there with Timo. Sorry, if there's a local infrastructure already for power. Well, there's a lot of local infrastructure already, but I've been there with Timo, and what they have is not sufficient for what we do. So it's great for building up, and it's great for having some lights on the field, but that's about it. So we have to put generators and do what we normally do. Yeah, also the ladder, yeah. So what's usually done is a distributed model. You have you have generators everywhere, and from there you daisy chain 64A cables as far, or 63. Okay. So the question is, if you have special power requirements, do you have to take that up with team power? Yes. So every village, there are some villages that have ridiculous power requirements, and they have to contact the power team in advance. So it won't be possible to get 125 amps on the day in advance. That's not very likely. Okay. So do you have anything, McFly?
So things I've been looking at was, for example, get the agreement with the CCC and get the money really on our bank account. That is getting closer, but the CCC also has a limited that has to avoid liability for certain areas. So they have to get certain agreements by the CCC board, by the limited board, and all of that is coming closer. We will have a written contract there really soon. We have an agreement on a contract, more or less, but in details there is nothing that is signed, and therefore it's nothing I would rely on. That's just water. The Netherlands, you should be used to that.
We're indoors.
We've been talking about the other tent. So there is an idea to have a slightly different tent as a speaker tent. So far, usually in conference, you have the point that you put a speaker in front of the audience. And I would like to circus alike, put the speaker in the middle of the audience. So there will be an idea to get one tent where the speaker is standing on a slightly smaller manege-style stage in the middle of the whole area, which will become a challenge for Produktionshaus, but I think you like challenges, right? it also gives you a lot of opportunities. For example, there will be two monkey seats. So if you have ever been in a proper circus, there's two people kind of sitting in the roof of the tent that can spot from down there and camera from down there. So we'll have two monkey seats. And that is, we also haven't signed a plan there. We have offers for 5 or 6 different tents in different sizes at the moment. And it's all clearly people that are not very used to work with nerds or have any understanding what we do. Actually, I spent most of the time talking to those people, explaining them what the hell we are actually doing, because it doesn't fit at all in any of their kind of... Yeah. So, anything on the design? Who of you is interested in the design? That's like 3 people. Okay. We have some submissions for the design.
Sorry? You are not very
understandable. Who of you is interested in the design? That was just like a question who is big. Okay. That is nice to see some interest in the design. We have, at the moment... 4-ish submissions. Of those, 2 of them were really late and way past the deadline, so we even have to discuss in the team if we kind of take them or not. Sorry? One of them isn't a design. It's a description of an idea how a design could look. But it's somebody who has a history of giving good designs, so I also don't throw it in the bin directly immediately. So that's why I like, if it would be somebody else and it's a Dutch person who has designed things in the past, that might be hanging here. It is still a very late submission without any graphical views so far, just an idea how you could do this in verbal. There is a second design from somebody from Hamburg, which is a JPEG that has been given to us like 3 days ago. And we have two submissions that are originally from where, as one of them is actually a team, and they sound like a group that would be very interesting to work with. But we do not have anything at the moment that we want to throw on a projector to not raise expectations there too much. But I can say there is progress, so you don't have the feeling there is just nothing at all happening. But it's not happening in the speed and especially the quality that we would hope for.
Anything else from NASA?
What? The deadline was in... Yes. We were pretty close of actually choosing something, and basically on that date somebody else submitted, two more submissions come in, and one of them is a very nice written statement, not written, in using letters. That's actually pretty nice, especially the idea behind that. And yeah, I don't think we should get in detail. The next time we will have something, but I expect that on the next meeting in January we actually do have a design that is agreed on, and this meeting can kind of finalize, give their verdict or not. I think the deco team might even start on the decision of the design. We'll see. Me personally, no. I would like to make the decision now. There are several people who have promised a design, and that is the same thing as always, that you have a large amount of people that promise that they give you something, and some of those promises still keep showing up on my ISC in every 4 or 5 days. I will still submit something. Like, dude, the deadline is like 1.5 months ago. So... unless somebody has a really awesome design at the moment, I would like to actually form a team with maybe 2 out of those submissions that don't necessarily exclude each other. I'm not necessarily a fan of mixing designs, but I think that the people in those group actually would benefit from working together with each other there. And maybe a solution is form a team out of those people and let them then decide. But that would take longer than a design group that has already formed takes a decision. Architectural? Yeah. In which way? Is the question was if the design is only visual or also architectural?
Tent shapes.
If possible, yes. But at the moment, none of the design gives that. Like none of the designs that we have at the moment would be nice to incorporate all this. We decided for the design to go pretty much with the cyber circuses coming to town theme. One of these submissions has picked that up, the other 3 didn't. I would hope so. I find that a pretty cool idea, but at the moment the submissions that we have don't give that. Any further questions regarding design or any of the other statements? Good. Does anyone have, as we have been sitting here and you've been thinking a bit, any more additions to the agenda that you wanted to have on there?
Yeah, the mini agenda of today. There's a wiki page, right?
That's the email address.
Okay. Stein, is that a... No. Any questions up there? I've wrote an email to the thing on the website, their contact email address, but I didn't get an answer on that. So if you want to help me get a follow-up when you know somewhere personally, which I had the impression, that might be easier. Yeah, I assumed that. A lot of the groups that we have to deal with are not as digital as we would hope to. Okay. Cardboard podiums.
They have podiums?
Yeah.
Made from cardboard.
Okay.
Yeah, because the tents are pretty small.
Mm-hmm. The website, we're going to look into this after this? Okay. The question was if the website also contains podiums and cardboard. We're going to look into this after this. Yeah, I was just told that I should repeat the questions for the speaker. So everybody on the stream, this is for you. Any further questions that I can repeat?
Can you repeat that?
Yeah, I was asked to repeat that, but I think we're now getting into the metasphere. So the idea for today contains that we will try to get an update from the teams. The last time we only had the chance for the teams to give a very, very, very brief statement of roughly 90 seconds. We took a lot more time for that this time. So if you and the teams, I think we'll just go down the list of the teams. Okay, we'll go down the list of the teams and ask somebody from front, and whatever your wishes, fears, or whatever you have, things you would like to show, we'll have a bit more time. I think planned on is 5 minutes, but seeing the amount of people, I think we might even have some more minute if you're well prepared to spend more time on that. So, do you want the mic? Yes. We have two microphones.
Yes, we have. So, if everybody's ready, we can go on with the teams. I have a list here, so we're going to skip a couple of them because we were already talk about that. After the team, you can have also questions and it can be answered, so etc. So my favorite one, Team Bar. And somebody was here from Team Bar. Yes, exactly.
Yes. For Team Bar, there hasn't been much activity since the last meeting, but we do have some vacancies. We need someone to a team lead, and especially people with the papers sociale hygiene, which is needed to run a bar in the Netherlands. So if someone has those or wants that, please contact us.
Okay, thank you. Any question for bar team?
We set up a simple bar in a flying circus, for example, with the Belgian village.
Come back. So the question was, who is going to set up a separate bar for flying circus? Or for villages? Or permits or something like that.
Yeah, there are some Dutch regulation about that. So if that's the idea, then we need to talk about it. and see how to incorporate it. The remark was that if you want to run a bar, then contact team bar or team permit to talk about it.
Any further question? I can bring it on. Okay, the next one on my list. Let's see. Build up and tear down. Anyone here from? Yes. Awesome.
So, not a great deal happened in regards to the build up planning because we are still waiting on confirmation from the scouts about the exact duration we have for build up purposes. We have some idea of how much time for build up and tear down we will probably have, but no real confirmations yet, so we didn't get too much in-depth planning yet. So there's not much to say here. Any questions? No, our team is mostly filled on both ends. I see a question. So, so the question is, do we have an indication of how much time we will have? I think from the top of my head that the current plan is for us to have roughly 8 days in build-up and roughly 5 days in teardown, if we include all, if you include the largest stretches of time. That includes some weekends, that includes some parts where only, I don't know, five people can be on terrain, but all in, something like that. So the question is, will there be sanitation during the build-up? And the answer is yes. There is a lot of infrastructure on the terrain which we can use, which includes toilets, which includes running water, which I think includes showers, but I'm not quite sure on that. Sorry? Teardown. Yes, also during teardown, absolutely. I will spend quite a bit of attention on making sure that our people are reasonably well cared for during build-up and, more importantly, during teardown work. Anything else? Yes. I think... So the question is, will there be special sanitation facilities for children? I suppose that the infrastructure team will make sure this will be there during... Oh.
Sorry,
Mike?
Sorry, we cannot arrange that from infrastructure. There will be toilets and such, but if you want to have special things for the family village, then we can take care of it. If there is budget needed, then sure, we can do that, but we have to distribute work. I cannot arrange everything myself. So if you want to get quotes for like special toilet seats for children, sure, get the quote, and then if that's needed, we have to arrange that.
However,
I think also that most of us have grown up with a pretty normal toilet seat and are used to pretty normal toilet seats. I wouldn't want to let them get used to normal toilet seats.
As said, it's a scouting area. They probably have facilities for children. Beyond that, I cannot make any promises about what we will have in regards to children infrastructure during build-up or tear-down. Anything else?
Thank you. And I have here communication somewhere, yes.
Thanks. Okay, so for guys who don't know me, I'm Eskimo, Marcel. Brenno was the team lead for communication, and last time we met, he asked me to take over because he had this great plan for Safe Harbor. For people who don't know, he has a boat since a couple of, you know, so that's where the idea sprung up from. And he's working on that very hard. So I'm stepping in to look for the things that need to be done for communication. We have been talking over Mumble a few times. Dave was there. Jan Volkorn, are you here? Great. You guys are awesome. So they bombarded me with a lot of stuff to read. I only finished a corporate education a few days ago, so I was very busy. But we're working on all that, and I'm very happy that you're both here. So I think later on today we'll have some drinks and get everything together. At this moment, it's a kind of a mess, but we'll figure that out today. So that's why I'm very happy that you're here. Of course, we are looking forward to the logo. So that's basically the communication bit. Most important for today is that I think we have to agree on what the communication team will do and what we won't, because all the stuff you sent me and I've been reading it all, it's a lot. So we have to organize that very neatly in order to be able to function on this terrain. So is there any questions on... Oh, already, okay. Yeah. Yeah, sure. Call for participation. That was the question. You're very welcome to join in later on, and we'll talk about that too. So just join us, and we'll see how we can work that out. Oh, we'll work that out. Yes, I heard there is a party after that, so. There will be drinking, so just join in. Yes. Another question? A media bar. Brenno's up there, I think. Brenno?
Yes.
Gaan we radio doen? Media bar? Radio? TV? Okay. There will be radio. That's always good.
So there will be radio. We are not planning on doing TV yet. Media bar like thing, so far not yet. Someone has an idea and wants to do it. Be my guest, but we haven't accounted for it yet. No. On our side, it will be smaller because we won't be doing that, and it'll be bigger because we're doing all AV together with former teams that were doing that. So we need to cut corners here and there, and that is one of them.
Okay. So radio, yes. And the Netherlands, we have a great history in broadcasting from the water, so that's that way we no problem at all.
Brenner, just a suggestion, maybe a media barge this time?
What? Yeah, why not?
Sure. The more boats, the merrier. Is that a challenge? Will there be regular shipping for the...
It's an invitation, not a challenge. Okay, any more questions? No, thank you.
Okay, the next one is content team. Please.
Hello. Since the last meeting, we had six submissions. Now we have 11 submissions, so it's going very slowly. There are submissions being added to our FRAP system, And submissions, I'm talking about lectures, keynotes, workshops, and also there is a movie being submitted. We still need to have a good strategy to be able to spread the word out of the cooperative participation. Until now, Walter and Arjen, since they give lectures very often, they are spreading the call for participation. And the rest of the team also, we have a list of mail lists where we did write to them and to ask people to respond to the call. I'm trying to assess people from other parts of the world that's not Europe. I'm especially send a lot of emails to South America, but till now not a lot of results. One thing is like we would like to ask everybody that's involved into organizing the orga to access your own networks to spread the call for participation. But when you do this, just tell us where. For instance, if you think of mailing list of to tell us which mailing list are you accessing, so we don't spam mailing lists with this call for participation. And I think that is yes, that's what I have to tell. Any questions? Tell. You're off.
Hello?
Yeah. Yes.
So I suggested one speaker a while ago,
yes.
And the response that I get, can you contact him? And I was like, okay, well, first, separation between project lighting and content teams,
yes,
is still apparent. But in general, like, okay, if someone does a suggestion, I think, can you pick that up as well?
It's like if you have these suggestions, the idea is that you just talk to this person and ask him to submit, because we do things through submission. So the persons that are, the people that are contacted that think, well, this is going to be a nice speaker, if you you can ask them to submit to the FRAP. So then afterwards being this curation moment.
But it doesn't always work like that.
In
this case, it's a university professor.
Yes.
And I don't think that he will actually submit something to FRAP.
Yeah, we're getting also a lot of pretty big people. We are searching, looking for pretty big people to, and we're asking them to submit things to FRAP. And because the idea is like they're not that cannot be big enough to don't be able to do this. But the main problem is to have one person that goes after this because at least at home, what we did is like we had the people that are chosen to give talks and lectures and whatever, and someone from the organization would organize this. We would manage this.
Okay, but isn't that especially the content team?
Yeah, we also doing this, but nobody picked up. Nobody was really thinking it was a great idea to go after this person, especially. Okay. That's so. If someone still thinks it's a great idea to have this person talking, just I'll say go after this person.
Okay,
that's the idea.
Okay.
For the team. No, we have closed since the last meeting. We have enough people on the team. We have closed the team participation.
So if people are going after the further speakers,
yes.
How do you want to handle that in the future? Because from my experience, also from talks, there is quite a lot of important speakers that you plenty have to chase. It just doesn't
yes,
work
absolutely.
The way that you say. Like if I want to talk to Dan Kaminsky or somebody, I can't say, it just doesn't work this way, saying submit something. That's just not how it works for at least the special people that we want.
Yeah, it is like that. But what Attila did is like, well, is someone here wanting to get this person, to chase this person, to be able to submit something. So, and it was in the list, and nobody in the list said, well, I do have time and I do have the energy, I do have the interest in going after this person. And if you have someone, just send an email and one of us
If we continue in that stage, will you open the org or the content team for further people that can chase potential speakers?
But we are chasing potential speakers. But maybe not the one you wanted to have there. You know?
Yeah.
You can submit it, and someone you we pick or not the work.
Okay. Yeah.
More question? No.
I would also kind of expect that everybody that submits a submission, that team content goes after every single person that is submitted from the team.
Well,
and that way of, we don't like that person, so we didn't go after that. I find that at least strange.
No, it's not I don't like that person. It's like we are going after people we think that's a cool. We're spreading the call for participation. If you say, well, the person H would be a good speaker, someone has to have the whole work to go after this person.
Yes, but I would expect that.
Yeah, but
that
why is this
content
person more? It's going to take.
I think everybody from this organization. I don't mean anybody from Sanity.
Yes.
I mean anybody from this group. If anybody from this group has somebody that they think that is cool for the talk and would ask you to go after them, I would kind of hope that at least one person in team content finds the time to actually do so. And if there is not enough people that actually do so, we might want to need to find more people for team content.
But well, what we ask is actually, if you think someone is a good person to speak, you talk with that person, say, well, would you like to speak or not? You know, if you have contact with the person, because if I'm gonna go after this professor, I'm not the one, the person that knows him. So as closer you are with this person that you think it's a good speaker, the better. So, but it's not exclusive to.
Isn't that kind of
cool? My work is, well, my work is not only going after the. Yes? Yes.
Yeah, so in this case, Kevin Warwick, he presented at What the Hack, and he does nice things with chips connecting to his nerve paths and everything.
Yes.
So I was like, okay, it would be great to have an update after 20 years.
Yes.
But I don't know him personally.
Yes.
I will be doing the same as you. Go to his website and send him an email.
Exactly.
And that is why you have a submission system. If you have great people you want to see there, ask them to submit something for that. If team content, then in their work, sees, hey, we have several topics we want to cover at SHA. Then they're like, okay, we have no speaker in this field of topic to speak. Then that is the point where they start going out for people and try to fill those gaps.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes?
May I still suggest a sub-team of like chasing? Because I found a couple of speakers that I thought, well, they are interesting, but I don't have the skills to write the correct email to that speaker to make make them make a suggestion. Yes.
Well, actually, I think what we can do, like if you send an email to team content, we can run through us, see if someone has contact with this person, someone has something more to say, and we can make an also an email. And I don't think we need a sub-team chasing, but we really can do this, and we really welcome suggestions. We had some email. He sent an email. We had yes. Yeah, we had some emails going back and forth about it. Yes. Exactly.
Not everyone has the skills to contact someone and chase him to do a submission. So it would be great if you can do it both. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, my interest would maybe be that we have a procedure, and also the I would like to, like, in the end, Jan is pretty much right. There has to be a submission in the submission system.
Yes.
And team content can't kind of drag everybody into the submission system to do that. And also, it is kind of a sign of commitment to actually submit something myself or by the speaker itself. That is true. But we also need to find a way how to handle recommendations by the community and the larger orga group. Because at the moment we have 11 submissions in the system, so the system at the moment that we have clearly is needs some improvement. But we also still have plenty of time. So I wouldn't lose the patience with team content there too quickly. Maybe we can get them to that we find a procedure how we do that kind of from now on, which is like at least, I think it would be nice that at least every submission is answered there. I also had given some ideas to the people with the strong ego starting this team content, and they pretty much told me directly that I'm sanity and have to keep my fingers out of there because not good otherwise because of what happened last year or last time, which I do understand. I think we have to get to a procedure, and just, I think Claudia got that, and we'll take that to the team, that we need to have a way of handling suggestions by the audience, by the orga and other people that are good in connected there. I think we need, she's right to the point that actually the people that suggest that need to go after the speakers, it think would also be helpful if the team content could help a bit. I kind of see that already, and I think that will work.
We're going to figure out, we have a meeting, and just after here, we're going to figure out a procedure, and we have also a wiki page, and we're going to add to the wiki page what's the procedure and what you, the rest of the team can expect from us.
Yeah, I think that would help a lot if we have a clearer way of actually communicating that.
Hello, you? That's a good idea. The idea was to have the team contents to make a template of invitation for submission. And we can do this and add it to the wiki.
I just want to say, I have friends, I have Yeah.
Well, we just got a president here.
Any further questions?
Yes? you accept it. Yeah, that's what I asked. The question was to how to prevent speaker to get the same email over and over again. That's what I asked in the beginning. To like, if you contact someone, just send us contact at SHA2017.org. Send us email. Say, well, I'm wishing or wanting. I'm contacting this person or this email list, so we don't spam people. Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. More questions? No?
Thank you very much. I have actually decoration on my list, but I think we covered decoration. Is it anything else? No, we didn't.
Decoration is different from design.
From design. Sorry about that. Yes, all right. Sorry. So I have decoration on my list. Decoration, please.
You've all seen me all motivated and fired up. Today I'm not motivated and not fired up. And actually I'm not a happy bunny at all. So this is going to be a bit of an airing of the grievances. Yeah, we did since the last meeting sweet fuck all. Because we're waiting for a design. And we see a lot of problems with the way that the design is eventually going to appear, hopefully. First of all, we have been asked for feedback on the call for design, which was by then called a design contest. And we provided this feedback, and it included a little list of things that should be included in the submission. We asked for there to be a logo, well, I think a font, some other things. And then that little list disappeared. So the submissions that were made did not contain these elements. We also made a little list of recommendations based on our previous experience. We asked that the submissions would keep in mind that we wanted something colorful, something welcoming, something that would welcome non-technical people as well, so it shouldn't be hard, techie. And if there were people present in the logo or anywhere in the imagery, then we wanted minorities to take priority. Well, there are no people present in any of the submissions, so that part is taken care of. But these recommendations disappeared from the call for design. As a result, we now have two submissions. I honestly cannot count the other ones, well, maybe three. They're all in black and white. It's really, really difficult to make the terrain look nice and look dressed up and like a whole event in black and white, as we found out in Ohm. So I'm having a hard time with this. We have one submission that is decent but does not have a team to execute it. We have one team that is decent but their submission is very meh. I mean, yeah, they were like, oh, let's make the world go around the corner. And let's make it pixelated, like 8-bit pixelated. Yeah, okay. So we're not very happy so far. We like the circus idea. It would have been good if that had come up before the call for design.
The circus idea wasn't originally part of the...
This is true, it came up later. So, yeah, I don't think actually we have any submissions now, sorry. So we haven't done anything because we can't, because it all hinges on the design. And I want to stress once more that design is very different from decorating, because design is the people who think of stuff and make pretty pictures, and we are the people who make it into things on the terrain, made of wood and stuff like that. Do you have a question?
Yes. I'm separating design and
why are the design and decoration separated? Because I'm an executor, not a designer. I'm not a great designer, but I can make really nice signs.
May I answer on that? The decoration team clearly has a very large stake in the design, as much as, for example, the website, the info desk with the booking booklet, and all of the other stuff. So decoration is, in my point of view, actually a large part of the design. But
we don't
decoration is a large stakeholder in the design,
yeah.
But it's not everything.
No,
so I think that made sense to actually separate it.
We make things on the terrain. We do not make booklets. We do not make websites. We make signs and a gate and stuff like that.
I didn't want you to make all the other things too.
That's good because I can't. I would do a lousy job.
So yeah, all of there is actually kind of lacking really, like I agree with Moom that we didn't have had a design submission that made me go, yeah, that's it.
Well, that's partly because none of them had any colors, which you might have had if you had not removed that recommendation from the call for design. Thank you very much. Yeah, I would like to know that. Why did you do that?
I didn't remove it. Like, I really, in the part that I, like, copy and pasted, like, I didn't... The one thing that got changed was the date, and that is the only way change I'm aware of.
Okay, I'll show you on the pad.
Yeah, maybe the problem is that a too early version of the pad was copy and pasted, but I didn't remove anything from on there besides that... Stitch brought up that the date is too tight and that was changed actually.
I can handle that,
me.
But I'm wondering about where someone drew little arrows about the parts with we want colorful and so on and said this needs to be
don't
removed.
Don't get me wrong, I want something colorful too. I don't want something black and white.
But that was your edit. So... maybe, but I just wanted this made very clear. It's an airing of the grievances. Festivus for all. Needs to happen now and then. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I would very much like to find a good solution. And what we really need right now is a design team. Yeah. That would be cool.
Yeah, I tend to take the point is that we have a team of people that is, I think, actually is highly capable, but their idea doesn't make me jump to the roof. It's the thing that at the moment I actually would take from all of these submissions. If you ask just for my personal questions, I would pick that one. Mostly based on the point that there is a proper team behind that.
Yeah, and if we can work with these people to make them make something that we would like to see, then... Claudia.
Shall we have a meeting about this afterwards? That we can really see to find out the solution?
Yeah, I don't know that you would be interested.
Yeah, also in the design.
Oh, that's true. That's true. I saw your emails there.
Claudia brought in the two people that actually are the kind of team that did that submission.
Yeah, this is true. This is true. Well, I'm not sure about today, but we should definitely have a meeting with those people as well and talk about this. Yes, more time should be spent on that.
Yes, I think it's important what we need
to
talk with each other.
Yeah, I very much agree.
Yes.
Okay, any more questions? Nope. Then I'm going to hand this back. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. And the next on this list for me is the family village. Okay, here we go. Hello.
Hi, I have a lot of questions about children because we make a lot of attraction for children. And together with Sabine, we do need more people, also for now, but also if you know some people who will like to help during the camp, that will be very nice to know. That can be also children from 16 till 18, they can help us. Till now we did make some organization or some planning, and we do have some question for the tents and for some things about infrastructure that we will do later. We get some contact with the people who can deliver laptops, so we can make some workshop for the children with code.org and some other. We are searching for people who will do workshops, and I would like to ask from every village who came that we can contact them and ask them to one or two people who would like to do workshops with children or some speech or something. And then we would like to also ask contact that when they talk with the speakers who will come to program, to ask them do they want and can do something with children. And we will try to make all planning and to workshops, but also to make nice things that children can play. That's for now. Do you have some question? Later I will have some people I would like to speak with, like with you about tents, to know some. Till. Sorry? We have two people and one who is at that moment busy, but he will like to, he's in a, he's a neighbor, can I say. You want to help us? Do you want to help us? Sure, then we can contact later. And please think about people you know that will come to the conference, and they will like to take 1, 2, 3, 4 hours at a day to help us during the conference to make it. And I want to ask who I can ask about Twitter account and public communication. So, okay, I will come to you later. Thank you.
Thank you. I have finance in my list. Anyone from finance? Nobody here from finance. Let's see the next winner in this game. Food court and vendors.
For food court and vendors. For food court and vendors, we actually even need to update the team. So that is a team where at the moment BugBlue is standing in there. But BugBlue kind of announced that he will pull out of there for external reasons.
Okay, so no one on food courts. Info desk. Yeah, I see someone moving. Hello.
So I'm here today for InfoDesk. We're working on getting the answers questions. At this moment, we have the infrastructure to, if somebody has questions for, as a visitor, they come at us and we can answer them. There were no questions yet, but the possibility is there. Furthermore, we also want to further look where exactly our scope of responsibility is. There are some questions about it, what is exactly touching other teams. So people like communications, we like to talk with you, all other teams that we were close to. We will contact you, and if you could contact us, that would be fine. All other teams, we need to provide every visitor with information. In the booklet, as questions, everything. We need your input. We make sure there is an infrastructure on the public wiki. We have a media wiki plugin that if you put a format on your own wiki page, it will end in the final FAQ.
But we need your input. If you could put questions there, if you could have any text that you want in a booklet, if you want anything on the public wiki, please contact us or make it clear on your wiki page and we will make sure it will come on the public wiki. So I want to thank you in advance for your help.
Thank you very much. I have infrastructures in my list. Anyone? Infrastructure? No? Infrastructure? Yeah, sort of.
You can come if you want.
No, it's not awkward. I said everything that
All right. Logistic. I saw someone from logistics, yes. And Mikey.
Okay, well, I'm not a head team lead, but I guess the other ones aren't here. So, not much has happened yet. We're still waiting for the train to finalize and train layout, so it's pretty important for us to know how that's going to be. One thing we do really need is a sub-team lead for off-site transport, so to get the stuff to the terrain. That still hasn't been anybody wants to do that, so if you know anybody that likes to arrange stuff and drive trucks and other fun stuff, let us know. That's all I can tell. I'll talk to you. Maybe.
Any questions?
Okay, thank you very much. And the next one on my list, let's see, again. Lounge.
Lounge, nobody's here from today. Like, I neither see DJ Paul Spock or no DVZ.
Okay, then that will be a quick list. Maps. I see some maps here.
Hello again. Well, I have a couple of maps there. I recently finished painting the terrain background. What has not happened in any detail yet is planning what we are going to do with the terrain, where the tents will be, where the food will be, where, I don't know, power will be, that sort of thing. But the terrain basics are now properly documented and will be on a web viewer thingy in a couple of days. Actually, it's there at a temporary location right now, but I won't bother you with that. What I'm still working on documenting in detail is the exact infrastructure on the terrain. For example, there's a lot of power stuff on the terrain, and there's sewage, and there's running water and all that sort of thing. There's a lot of it. Sorry? Fiberglass, yes, that too. I am working on documenting all that stuff, and it's a bit tricky because all the data the scouts have given me so far are concepts that are a year and a half old and that I know to be mostly right, but not actually right. So that's a bit slow, but most of the rest is there.
Any questions?
Once? Twice? No, I'll repeat the question. If you have any specific requirements regarding where things should be, should you tell me? No, you mostly should tell the people who deal with that. So in this case,
I think
power.
Especially in your case, which is possibly the heaviest power requirement on the whole field, you want to talk to power directly.
And then it will get to me.
One thing that we need input from you is on large structures. So every large structure, which is a very broad definition, but we need construction plans on that for the permit, but we'll get to that later.
So I'm just about to start now with Attila and others on planning where we're going to put the tents and what we're how we're going to use the fields in detail. So that should become publicly available, shall I say, in during the next month-ish, I guess. All yours.
Thank you very much. I try to not step on everything. So the next on my list is knock. Here we go.
Knock, knock. my name is Arjan, or AK from NOC, and there is not much update since the last meeting, but we're kind of busy preparing for upcoming Congress in Hamburg. But we are working on getting the uplink done. So there's Eurofiber already on the field, and we need to plan a meeting with Eurofiber to see what the cost would be to rent this fiber, so we could have a dark fiber going to Amsterdam, and from there we have all of the possibilities we need to get a decent working uplink. We're also thinking about the network design or the planning phase. We need to work with the maps team to and since we already have quite a lot of maps from scouting, and there's a lot of fiber infrastructure already on the field. We need to work with that information to see where we would need network and how much equipment we would need. And we're also working with the event infra project to see how much equipment we need. And I think there's already quite a lot of stuff there, so things are looking pretty good. In terms of the network design we're building, if you have any special requirements for your project or for your teams, then please let us know. I think in a little bit later on in 2017 we might have some kind of form if you want to request network in a certain location, which we didn't think about ourselves, then you can fill in that form and then submit your network request in a certain location. Right?
Thank you. And the next one is a list in POC,
nobody's here.
All right. Then let's see.
From the POC, the team will happen. The team is active, but all of the teams that are also very strongly active on the 33C3 in Hamburg, they kind of have timing issues at the moment because it's also a preparation for the Congress. So the POC didn't have time this time to drive over here, but they promised to come again in January. Okay. POC has sent a list to all of the teams, an email to all of the teams regarding if you need power connection in your a phone connection in your team. So in case you do need, for example, if you in your hardware village want to have a 1920 old from 1920 old Bakelite phone, talk to them. True for every team here. If you want to in your team location or with your team needs either a landline phone or a DECT phone, please let the POC team know. Yep, you will be able to call.
Repeat the question.
The question is was if the phone system also works for the security. Yes, you will be able to call 112, for example, which is the international first aid number to reach directly out to the firefighters and the that services. No, I think 112 works on all of those events too.
The 112 on the tech phones at least went directly
directly to our internal security.
Yeah, it went directly to the medics, and then they forwarded in case of directly then to the external security. So yeah, there is a step in between with our own team. But for example, if the phone line is not used, it goes then directly. But all of that works. And if you hurt yourself on the camp and you, as with your hardware village, somebody put the finger under the hammer, dial 112, that will be the team to talk to. And they might just call somebody externally. Does this fulfill your answer? Any more questions?
Then we move on. The next theme here is, especially not on this list.
Permit.
Yeah, permit. Did we cover permit completely, Attila?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Unless anyone has questions.
Anyone question what came out about permit?
I think after that is power, which I feel covered also, unless you all disagree.
No.
No, one disagreement, one would be enough.
Your voice doesn't count.
Just if you come here, that counts. Yes. Produktihaus.
And they have a presentation. Awesome.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Woohoo.
Almost like they understand their role.
Yeah, well, we have the stuff, so we need to show something, right?
Yes.
Wow.
The product he has after all, right?
Yeah.
So.
All right. I think I'm still vice team lead, but yeah. We prepared a budget, and I'm not sure if I want to present the amount. So it is a hidden slide for now, and we can vote on if you want to see it or not, and if we want to stream it or whatever. So our budget is calculated on this set of assumptions. We have every stage has their own infrastructure. We have stage for 100 people, for 400 people, for 1,000 people. And we do radio, and we need something to monitor that all the streams that we're going to broadcast to the world are correct. And if villagers are starting to send porn, we want to prevent that. So we want to have monitoring for every thing. So, yeah. Well, there are things we can't do. So, well, depends on what. Don't get into details for now. So we calculated with six stages, two for 100 people, two for 400, and two for 1,000. If you want to add circus tents, that might need a little extra infrastructure. So, yeah, one circus tent, but. No, but one circus tent is already a challenge for us. So if you want to check what we did for our assumptions and whatever, and what our calculation rules are and what we're going to rent and what we're going to buy and whatever, check our wiki. So far, everything is still being run by volunteers. We need people to build lightning, put up the cameras. We need people to tear down all infrastructure that we need, and we also need during the event people manning cameras, manning lights, giving people microphones, giving people headsets where necessary, things like that. We don't, for now, assume that we need to build our own tents and build up the stages. And we hope we can get enough power because, well, we need to put up big beamers and things like that. Well, these are all obvious. This is what people have all stated more or less, or whatever. The POC has been assigned because we filled in the form already. And our budget, we have not, how shall I say that? We don't have added any or subtracted all the discounts that we can get because we don't yet know how many days we need to build up yet. And we tear down. And there's some equipment we can borrow, but not everything. And the big money tickets are not the things that we can borrow. So, do you want to see the total amount? Am I allowed to show the total amount? Okay. Then we'll unhide the slide. Yeah. So that's 188,000 euros.
So that's
yeah. there is an unknown unknowns column of a 20% addition for 20%, but no. Okay. Yeah. Well, I don't know. Yeah. Perhaps. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, well we do a lot for the event as well, so. Yeah, yeah, this is what we just added up, a thing where we need this amount of tents, this amount of microphones, beamers of various kinds, screens.
Is the VOC team?
Yeah.
Is the VOC team included in there, like the gear that you get from them?
Yeah. We don't have computers for at the stage for streaming. We didn't add that because we know we can probably either borrow that from C3VOC or borrow it from somewhere else or whatever. These are all, yeah. Yes, of course. Been there, done that. I think that's three meetings ago, yeah. We did allow ourselves a few servers so we can make sure that we have the stuff on our own hardware, but that's not a lot of money in the end either. It's the little things that count up quite rapidly. So, yeah, do you have any questions?
That's one expensive radio.
That's a budget, and there are a lot of things in there that can be borrowed. But again, that's not a big ticket thing. It's the big stages that cost a lot of money. The what? Oh, that's the just adding up the what we estimate that the stages would be.
Okay, so there will be
6 stages. 2 for 100, 2 for 400, and 2 for 1,000. That's what we knew. That's what we thought we remembered. If the stages, if we do it differently, no. But it's a spreadsheet we have, and if you assign different things, a different amount will come out. But for if you do 2 of each, this is the amount that you'll get.
Yeah. Well, you have to compare to the guesstimate. You roughly came up with 4 times the amount that you now need. Which is average among all of the teams, so that's not the only team that we have to have a discussion with, so don't worry.
No.
And I think that's perfectly normal in an organization that a team wants some money to do all big and great and awesome things, and then we need to have a look in
just
the end what is possible.
There is nothing awesome in here, unfortunately. I wish.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. Thanks, guys.
Any other questions?
Thank you. Thank you for showing us everything. I have Team Safety on my list. Anyone from Team Safety? Should be, yes? Okay, then. Safety.
Oh, yeah, we don't have that. Yeah, we do.
Yeah? Yeah. Here we go.
Right, good afternoon. So it's my first time at one of these in-person get-togethers, so I haven't met anyone yet. So, I'm Matthew, and out of the sub-teams we've got, so safety covers, security, first aid, water, and traffic. So, I have first aid, and I don't really know about anything else. Water.
Yeah?
Yeah?
With first aid, it's maybe we would like to ask you all if you feel like taking an exam. And most of the insurance companies cover your education. So we've got a very nice offer where you can learn in 2 days how to do first aid. You get a real diploma and everything. And we need people, loads of people.
Can I ask a question then?
Yes. Okay, the question is how expensive is it if the insurance company doesn't cover it? It's 185 euros and it's in the safe harbor budget already. So we have some places, but of course, if an insurance company does cover it, that would really help out. And for instance, mine does. So, yeah.
Can we deal with the bigger picture first and then focus on that? Right. Let's. Okay, cool. Right. So the issue we've had, I believe, I'm not sure if it was since the last meeting or before the last meeting, but the meeting with the municipality, that some stuff, interesting stuff came out of that. For example, they're happy with first aid certificates from any European country. But one of the more interesting things for us is that if you take first aid, for example, volunteers who are doing first aid need to be doing nothing else while they're doing first aid. We can't have a pool of safety people. We need, I think, a minimum of like 8 first aiders and possibly a healthcare professional available all the time. 8 minimum. Some estimates say 12.
8 is not a lot for that.
Like it's a absolute minimum of 1 per 750 participants.
Can we do in shifts?
Exactly. That's the idea. The idea would be we could have volunteers do 6 or 8 hour shifts. Longer the better, because then people have to do fewer. But where they're kind of free to go around the event and enjoy the talks and things, but they are only available. They're available immediately if needed. And that would probably be in addition to a central field hospital or first aid post or something that's responsible for
this. There is a group of first aid people from the CCC, which I've desperately tried to get you in contact with, which did not work well on the CCC side because they're in 33C3 preparation side. Is anyone of your team by chance on the 33C3?
Not that I know of. I think people talked about it and no one was available.
Volkorn, can you help in getting them in contact? Yeah, but it stalled on the cert side. It didn't stall on their side. It stalled on the CCC side.
Okay.
Because that would be a pile of at least 16 to 20 people who have, like, if Europe, the reason why they didn't apply so far was that they had the assumption that they need a Dutch first aid license.
I see.
Like, if any license from any European neighbor country, for example, Germany, works, then we might even have 2 doctors or things
like
that.
Well, the doctors are regulated by the EU, so that's harmonized. Healthcare professionals are fine.
Okay.
First aid, certain first aid certificates have a symbol on that says they're taught in accordance with the European guidelines on first aid.
Then it's fine.
They're fine.
Okay.
Yeah. I think there were other questions. Yeah. A bit louder. Sorry. Absolutely. Yeah. Please do. Sorry, the question was, is it worth contacting us if someone already has a first aid diploma or works in a hospital or whatever? Yes, if someone's interested in helping out, please get in touch. That would be great. Yes.
Do we need extra certification for technical environments, for example,
That's not something we've specifically been told we need yet, but I don't believe we've explicitly asked. So if you remind me, we can put that on the list of things to bring up next time that gets discussed with the municipality. But the same as the permit stuff, the municipality set the rules, and we are just coming up with what, we're just asking for each thing kind of what their requirements are.
The flank circus might actually be an interesting challenge there, that's true. Because they use and operate a lot of dangerous tools, just put it this way. We might want to have a further discussion about safety and security and first aid in the flying circus, because if somebody gets hurt, it's very probable in your premises.
Yeah, another question. Say again, sorry. Security, right. I don't know that much about security because I'm in charge of the little first aid sub-team. However, I know from the discussions we do need licensed security guards. I believe we've kind of settled on the fact that we don't need that many, so they'll probably come from an agency that specializes in this stuff. Well,
I think the plan was to get some people the certification because I saw an offer for training for that going through. For security.
Perhaps.
The security team, there has been some discussion around that, and we need that for the permit anyway. But the great thing is that we don't have to hire external security if we form the security team ourselves. But that is something that we really have to look into because we need to form the team and all the regulations around it. Well, we discussed it earlier, and how many people we need for security? Well, we probably need at least four or five that are in charge on the schedule during the event, and obviously for every position and wherever they deem necessary, we need people, but that's less important.
I think the figure we're quoting at the moment is, volunteers-wise, we're going to need about 50 to 60 people working in the team during the event.
Exactly. But
that's across first security, first aid,
yeah,
whatever the others are.
Yeah, but that's something for later.
Exactly. But that might answer the question somehow.
I think team volunteering has that already.
Good. Okay, so the question was, what's the plan if we don't get enough volunteers?
Is that volunteers in total or first aid volunteers?
First aid.
If we don't get enough first aid volunteers, we have to rent them.
Yeah.
Plainly. We need to have a certain amount of volunteers. We need to have them to make the event happen. So that is a hard line. If we really fail completely in getting to connections to all the neighboring communities and all the other groups that we could still talk to, we in the bitter end would have to hire them, and I already have a contact there. Yes. Remark on the previous, first of all, we can use the money for, we can possibly find some money for the training, and it got a recommendation that in previous event they were sponsored, hired, as in they were hired but a company paid for them, if I understand that correctly.
That's, we will need healthcare professionals, yes.
That is even better, having healthcare professionals. When the professional on that point means they have a training, then it's really a lot better. When professional on that point means they want money for that. Yes. Yes. They will learn something. Completely new ways of people being injured.
Okay.
Any further questions?
I don't have anything else to say.
Sorry, I did cut you short. Did you have anything else?
No, I just said I don't have anything else to add, so. No more questions?
Can the posse on the higher ranks laugh less loud, please?
Yes, thank you very much. And the next one in the list, if you're already being loud up there, Team Sysadmin. Thank you.
Yeah.
Actually, he wasn't
may
loud.
Until they're down here give a short question. My plan would be that we go down to the list. We had S, so we're coming to the end of the list anyway. And after that, I would recommend that we make a break. Is that okay with everybody? Because I think we're all getting slightly...
Yeah, exactly. But also, what I would like after the break is for the not just the team, but the projects, because we have some project that we didn't update it for a while. So, okay, sysadmin.
Hi there. Well, for all the faces that don't know me just yet, I'm the other Matthew from Team Sysadmin. And basically, I don't have too much to say for our team at the moment. Everything's going pretty well. We're currently spending our time building the ticketing system for buying tickets and assisting with other teams and getting it integrated, like the info desk, for example. At the moment, the thing we need is if anybody has connections to colo providers or to data centers, we're looking for one or two U's to host a server specifically for the ticketing system. Go ahead. Okay. But so basically we're looking for colo providers, and that is about it, more or less. Unless any of my teammates have anything else to say. Yeah, form system could be good for this. And I think the other... Oh, right. Okay, so the question was more or less about people who are requesting VPSs, and we should create a process for this or some kind of solution to or a formalized white paper or such. Another thing is that for anybody who has a ticket or a request, please email sysadmin@sha2017.org because using IRC... is a bit messy for us to handle because in the daytime we're not very responsive there. And if you forget it on the wiki, we have our contact page and all the services available as well. And I think that's about it for our team, more or less. Excellent.
Okay.
Thank you very much. And the next tickets. One in the list is tickets and entrance. Tickets and entrance somewhere as
you
a team.
Something to that? Do you want me to say something to that?
Come on.
Hi, everyone. I don't have a lot to say just yet. Me and Mr. Seeker started to fill in the team page at some point, so it's we are waiting to really get going in spring with especially the entrance part, and the ticketing system is set up, but some improvements are made, and I think McFly can continue from that.
Go ahead. Questions? Then you can. Go for McFly.
Yeah. For the ticket system, the plan is to, well, not the plan. The requirement is to have the ticket system up and running by the Congress because I added a point of D33C3 later. We'll be announced on the Congress in the closing event in an Apple-like, one more last thing. On the Congress, CCC Congress. And the plan is that by that the ticket system works. So when the announcement comes, like on those Apple events, I'm not an Apple fanboy, by the way. I don't have any hardware from them. But I think they're great in communicating. And I think I would like to have the same thing that on the Congress, when we announce the Congress, when we announce the camp, the ticket system needs to work so we can directly sell tickets in this moment. So we are then able to say, that is the SHA, that is the thing that's happening next summer, and you can now buy tickets. Questions? Yes. I want to have the general design by that. I want to have the contract with a scout. You're repeating the question. If that is the right order, if we don't have the permit and the contract by them?
So the contract, actually I was hoping it was signed, but it really has to be signed by then, period. We can't sell tickets without having the contract. The permit, though, that's perfectly normal. For all previous events that was arranged like in April, May, that's simply how bureaucratics work, and there's nothing to be done about that.
We have an understanding in general how the permit will look like. We have an understanding about how in general the event will look like. And a requirement for me to say, yes, we go live with the sales, is that we have the contract for the location signed. Everything else... I'm fine with a good understanding which direction we go. For me, by the way, also a good requirement for actually saying, yes, we'll open the ticket sale, would be that we have a working budget. So that is also something that has to be working by then. But also, if we don't, we have the problem that IFCAT, as I'm... Actually, I think the only one from IFCAT here at the moment isn't necessarily having that much money that we can finance everything beforehand. So we kind of have the requirement of making the sales also a bit earlier. Any further questions here for the ticket system? You had one. Yes, I think the contract, and the contract and the budget, which would be.
Well, for example, in the ticket shop, I think you wanted to ask people for how long they plan to stay, which means that I want to have a build plan ready.
No.
So you sell a ticket for the main event, which is from 4 till 8 August.
No, that will be the build-up and take-down coordination will happen. And the question was that do we have an announcement of when people actually arrive? That is time-wise connected. There will be a volunteering system set up by them. Actually, I think that is already set up.
The angle system is
already up. So you do not say in the ticket system how long you're going to say. You say that in the angle system for the volunteers. And for us, the main part is that we get this whole thing going. Actually, the contract with the venue is usually the only only contract you have signed by then. So I don't find that very uncommon. Very often, I've seen a lot of events where the contract for the venue was not signed at that point even. But there has been an agreement between the people that do it that in the way how it looks, but the detailed contract hasn't been signed. I would even be, in case of, I hope we are not in this situation, I maybe would even be fine with that. We'll not have a final budget by then. We'll have a lot better idea where the budget goes to, and really I would like to see the contract with the scouts signed. Any further questions? So one of the things is that the team ticket and entrance is at the moment rather thinly staffed. As it will not only mean the site, the selling of the tickets on the website itself, but only also the entrance. We will need some people that help with that besides volunteers. So if any one of you knows somebody who wants to do something at the entrance, please add yourself to the wiki page. Or how do you want to have that? Yes.
So the next team is Team Villages. Anyone from Team Villages? Village team?
I didn't see anybody from the team here.
Yeah, okay, I have an upgrade on that because I see in still a Wiki Webmind and Bravo, and they sort of not doing it anymore. That's what I sort of heard, yes. So I know Sva was also in a team who is going
yeah,
to do
and
it.
Leah and
yeah.
Some more.
But I don't see them here at the moment, so
no. They're all preparing the Congress.
Yeah, I thought so. And Team Volunteers. That's the last team. Here we go.
I don't have quite a lot to say except that we're currently waiting on the permit to be signed for the date, and we've been busy getting our budget approved.
Okay, any question to Team Volunteers? Yeah. Okay, so we can have a break for like 10. Oh.
I would make let's talk really quick. We are a bit ahead in the schedule, I think. So
yeah, I know. Then you are with?
So we're a project team. I'm from the Flying Circus project. Would like to give an update. I don't really understand how the division between teams and project teams works, but I'll do this anyway.
No, let's go ahead.
Okay, so we presented the project at the last meeting, Pixel Bar. Really quick recap for a person that weren't there. We plan on setting up workshops with staff with tools people can use, so a wood shop, an electronics lab, stuff like that. And we want to provide an area where people can hold workshops, which is confusing because it's workshops twice. So since the last meeting, we wrote out what a concrete version of what we plan on doing. That's on the wiki, so please go and read that. We created a list of tools and machines we need in the workshops that is linked to from our wiki page. So if you're interested, please look at it. It's still work in progress. So if you see anything on there that's missing, please add to it. If you see any tools you or someone you know or your hackerspace can provide, please let us know because we're trying to crowdsource all these tools. Next up, we need volunteers to staff the workshops. There's going to be some pretty dangerous machines there, and we need permanent supervision of these machines to make sure we don't harm either the machines or the people using them. So if you have any expertise in woodworking, fabrics, textiles, electronics, or you know anyone, let us know. We still need volunteers to do that. Next up, the workshops can be used during teams during build-up. So, for example, team decoration can use a workshop to build signage or stuff like that. If your team wants to use the workshop we are building, please let us know who you are, what you are building, what tools you need, and by when. If we don't know you're going to use these tools, we can't really make sure they are there when you want to use them. We have some questions for specific teams. Projectleiding, we need to talk about infrastructure, we need to talk to a lot of people. There is a possibility that we don't know yet, we need to talk to your team. So please read our wiki page. If we need to talk to you, get in touch. So that's it. Are there any questions? I don't think so, so I'll pass the mic on to you.
Okay, then quickly I have also budget as a project, and I think we have here Jinx. The badge. The bash thing you have, yes. Okay, I look up there, but it's also here. Okay.
Thank you. We just finished our first hardware prototype, which is really exciting. It's mostly just the display and the ESP that we're putting on it. But we need help. We need help with people who can write firmware. But mostly we need help trying to get sponsorship. We cannot make the badge happen or exist for 6,000 people unless it is almost completely sponsored. So if anyone has contacts for maybe PCB fab houses or companies who can sponsor parts, manufacturing, that kind of stuff, then please let me know. I guess that's about it. Thank you.
Okay, any question? No? No? Okay. And the last one is Safe Harbor. Reno? Yeah. And I think we have project also as a website. A project, is it?
Yes. Hi. We have a budget that has been approved. We are now in need of loads of boats, and we are in need of loads of volunteers for having the best place. And we've become a sub-team of safety. So now we are a project, a village, and a sub-team. And I think that's for now the most we can do. We are really waiting for the permit and stuff to move ahead. So yeah. Yeah, and I'll ask again. If you feel like helping out and doing first aid, that would really, really, really help, because team safety will be also at the harbor, so that makes it useful and needed. And my biggest concern is that somebody is drunk and falls into the water at night, so that's really why we need loads of swimming first aiders. Basically, I don't trust you. That's just the whole.
Is there any question? Here we go. Don't run out.
Yeah, there are many places, so yeah. And actually the first aid training that we are organizing is one who also, besides the first aid, also deals with specific water issues. So getting people out of the water, and et cetera. So that's the cool part of it. That we haven't set dates yet, but somewhere in February, March, I would say.
Are you going to
announce it? No, I'll keep it secret. Yes, yes, definitely I'll announce it. And early, of course, because we want to as many people to join as we can handle. Maybe we have to organize it multiple times. Yay. Do you need drinks at the safe harbor? Yeah, well, we have a huge ship where we have a bar, so yes. And there's an interesting part on watery stuff. It's not part of the camp. So glass bottles, etc. are allowed.
Glass bottles are allowed everywhere.
Oh, I thought I had an advantage and now I don't. Oh. Yeah. Sorry, hey,
will you?
Yes, I guess so. Yes, there will be rum. If you vote for me in the next elections. Yeah. Any other questions? Yeah. Yeah, please help out, because I think it's going to be one of the coolest things that's going to happen. Of course, everybody thinks that's of their own. Well, that depends, of course, on how many ships we have, but we are aiming on expanding the docking place with 80 meters, so that would be huge. That's huge. No, that's doable. Yes, one of the things is that we have got... Sorry? Oh, I have to repeat the question. If there are things also with water and children, yes, there are things with water and children. No, one of the things is as soon as the ships are in, the basic rule is that ships don't leave. So it's not that there is constant movement, and that gives a splendid opportunity to organize loads of nice stuff. You can swim there, you can use a canoe, etc. And of course, you can have like remote controlled boats, let's say water drones, that you can have races, etc. And all sorts of workshops, so it offers a lot of opportunities. And if a ship needs to leave, we've got basic rules on how that works, and it will always be guided, so that it is really a safe harbor. And of course, every ship will get their own privacy shield, but that's a whole different story. Any other questions?
Okay, thank you very much. I think that was about a project. I don't know what the situation with the website, if it's a project or different group are doing it. Yes, I'm watching you. Yeah? Oh, come on. Yeah. So I repeat it, if anyone would like to part of the sort of project that is including the website, then please start to talk to you, to Reality Gaps. So I think we can take the stream now down and having like a half an hour break and get the people to meet each other and talk to each other and stuff like this. And also I would like to know how many people would like to stay for here for food. Hands up, please. Hands up for food. Around 6. Yeah, if you're not time. In there. Time. Around 6 o'clock, but if I want to have it in 6 o'clock, I have to order it now. So... There is a list, but I was there only last time, so that's why I was... How many people are vegetarian?
Vegetarians.
Only yeah. 1, 2.
Three.
Vegetarians. 4. No vegetarian. Good. So I only
total,
have.
3 of them vegetarians.
3 of them vegetarian. Good.
I think let's order for 25 or something like that.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Free to go. If we.
The stream. The stream ends
now.
As of here and now.